Your big pass, make a snack.
Nigga, I'm back out, that's on the pack out. Big boy, straight up finished. I was in the trap house, chillin' with the Mac out. Gang gave me my members. Nigga, we ain't turn no sticks round here, just glitch round here with a spinner. Nigga, don't take no peace round here, everybody over rush your sister. I had a check, fell in love with it.
That's clean right there, dude.
This Wholesome Podcast, Wholesome B. Mitch, Wavy Trey with the hat today. And we also got neighbor Terry in the building from the West.
Shout out to the neighbor West Coast shit. Hey, before we start, nigga, check us out on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts and shit, IG, whatever. Make sure you like, comment on that good shit. Share it too.
And also, today's episode is brought to you by Noor Accounting. You know, they do your taxes. Anything accountants do. I don't know all what accountants do. I just know they do taxes and shit.
Shout out to them. Shout out to them.
Make sure your bread is right.
Make sure your bread is all
good. Yeah. Make sure ain't nobody stealing from you. Make sure ain't nobody stealing from you.
No, facts. So, you know, you got to support all these black businesses. But what I want to know today, though, from y'all is like, we all single, right?
Yup.
You know, we all getting older, though. So I want to know, what's the difference between like a good woman and a right woman, the right woman. So a good woman and a right woman, what's the actual difference? Like, is it the same thing? Is there a difference? I mean, it's a lot of good women. I'm sure we've all come across a good woman before, but why wasn't they the right one?
They probably good, but they might pressure you to do some shit that you might not be ready for. Like, you still, as a young man, we're kind of old now, but as a young man, you are, like, we still growing into ourselves, trying to learn ourselves, so they try to pressure you, be like, oh, you want to be with me, be in a relationship and shit, you need to be this type of guy. I'm still growing into this type of guy.
So, because they pressure you, that makes them not the right one?
Are you ready for what the fuck she pressure you for?
I'm saying, what's your hold up? If it's a good woman, why she got the right one?
I'm being me. I'm still growing as a man. Mm. Can I still grow?
Feel me? Maybe she's trying to help you grow, though.
She might be, but I'm growing too. But I grow at a different pace than she might want me to grow at.
So you saying it's all on you? So you saying a good woman is the right woman as well?
Yeah, but she
you
can
just ain't
be
ready for the right woman.
Yeah, like yes, it happens.
See, I'm a little different. I feel like sometimes the good girl might be the good girl, right? Mm-hmm. But she might not be the right girl, because a good girl could be like a whole little checklist. Like, bam, this bitch got this, 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 mm-hmm. and this. But then you look at the, like, damn, she don't even like fucking like that.
Yeah.
She don't even like sucking my dick.
Fact.
She don't like doing, like, you, like niggas like certain shit. Like,
in fact,
some niggas is freaky.
No, you're right. Fact, the right one got mad at my characteristics. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm turned up shawty, you feel me, when I can be. I like doing other shit, fucking whatever shit, but you try with me, shit, do you like girls? Like, I like girls, shit, that might be the right one. It ain't got to be the good one, might be the right one type shit.
You got to have fun, you feel me?
Yeah.
Like, some girls don't like to have fun, but they the good girl. You know what I mean? And then also, it's like one of those things where it's like, all right, you cool, you super good, you got your shit together, everything's great, you a good girl, but I don't know if you're the right girl because... Like, you know, nigga, if you smoke weed, you're like, damn, I wish my bitch smoke weed. Because, nigga, when you smoke weed, everything different. Yo, the movie different. Nigga, the food tastes different. Nigga, you're like, damn, this half-baked ice cream tastes bomb, nigga. You sitting there, nigga, you might eat some pussy. Like, nigga, what the fuck? This shit tastes different, right? But then she don't really understand
right
what that she is because she's like, here.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It smells weird. And you're like,
The
fuck? You but, I mean, girl. So... The way I look at it is like this. I mean, just because it's a good girl, they might do them things as well, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's some good women that do them things as well.
Yeah.
I mean, for me, it's just about compatibility. Like,
yeah, know, so
some good women, they're just not compatible with
me.
Yeah, some are,
so the right one is the more compatible one.
Yeah.
But what if they compatible? Or what if they compatible? Because I feel like there's levels to being compatible, right?
Yeah. Because
you know what I mean? Yeah. If you could be compatible, like, financially... Like yeah, mature level, whatever the little
variations.
Yeah. But then it's like small shit. And sometimes the small shit be bigger than big shit.
Mm. Yeah, no, same shit. Yeah,
like,
shit.
Simple, like little shit. Like, you're like, damn, stuff. Like, why you always, like, what, like, how would you feel it'd be like, this is the right girl. Everything is good. Mm-hmm. But she slept in pajamas all the time.
Yeah, no, that's probably a no good for me.
Like,
yeah,
all the time, she got a one-piece on. So.
Yeah, no clothes shoddy.
You know what I mean? But everything else matches up. She compatible. She cool. She got all this. She got all that.
What are you sleeping in pajamas for?
That's something I could tolerate.
That's what
she feel.
That's what she like. That's
her. That's just her. Yeah.
That's her. She like, yo, this is what I like. This is how I feel.
Is she willing to take them off when I'm ready?
Nah, she like, that's how she feels. How she gets her sleep.
You might be, y'all might have sex, but she putting those back on.
No, that's cool.
You think so? I'm like, nah, what the
fuck? No, I mean, as long as you're willing to take them off. It's a lot of work. It's maybe at 3 a.m. when I'm tired. Like, I'm just trying to slide in.
I'm trying to slide in.
But if you're willing to take them off, which is a lot of work, I might could deal with it.
But nigga, nobody is trying to fuck and then cuddle with somebody with a whole like onesie on. Like, come on, my nigga.
I'm okay with her being comfortable. She won't be comfortable.
I don't know. I never went through that. I ain't gonna lie.
I went to college in North Dakota, bro. There's some conservative hoes. Like,
wait, yeah,
that even make sense?
No, conservative hoes is 100% a real thing.
But yeah. How though? Like, how can you be a conservative hoe?
Listen, I don't know, but it definitely happens.
Can they fight with themselves? They contradict themselves. So they said they feel like if I do this, this part is okay because they think it better.
That ain't a contradiction. Some people just like to be publicly conservative and privately just nasty as they want to be.
Bitch,
ain't nothing wrong with that.
But
bitch,
what if,
be nasty.
I like them type of girls.
But what if you like bitch, be nasty. What if you like a hoe, right? But you can't bug.
What you mean?
Like
that don't mean
like your sex sucks.
That happens too. I've definitely come across.
But how can you be a promiscuous hoe? I gotta stop.
That's a real thing.
No disrespect to y'all, but how can you be promiscuous as shit? Right?
A promiscuous free spirit.
But then when you get them in the room,
can't suck no dick.
You like, what the fuck? You frozen?
That's a real thing.
Yeah, they can't suck no dick properly and shit. Like, it's an issue.
That's a real thing. I done come across that a couple times.
I'm
telling
you,
like, what's going on?
It be confusing me because, like, how you gonna give me some pussy today and tomorrow act like
it ain't happened
and nothing even happened? It's like, and then niggas do that too, though.
Niggas do that.
So I've done that.
No.
I might be conservative, but I might be.
So why you gave a dick that day, but not the next day? Was her shit whack? Was it loose?
Maybe you just didn't want to.
See, me, it'd be a little different. It's like, I don't want to hang out with you 2 days in a row. Unless I fuck with you as a person. If I fuck with you today.
That makes sense.
And then tomorrow, like, I wake up, I'm like, I don't even want to. If I just fuck
your personality,
you
might not be that great.
You like that?
Nah. Your personality might not be that great for real.
Yeah, because it's just like niggas know, like, all right, you look good. I want to fuck.
Yeah,
but
there's more to it than
time. I just
is a lot of work.
I just seen a meme today. Like, you feel me? The finest female woman, the finest woman, you feel me, out there. Every nigga want to get with her, but then you realize why she's single. Character flaw. It could be the same for a dude. So don't just like, you feel me, chastise me. But it's a woman who look good as fuck, bad as fuck,
and they strange.
They're strange.
And like strange in a real way, like insecure, or they just don't have a confidence enough to be like, yo, I'm out here.
All that shit. So it could be insecurity level because shit, I done went through so many guys and shit. I got 3 kids and shit. My value might have went down. Or it's
we not gonna let you get away with that.
The
one.
Value though?
No. How does their value go down because of whatever you're talking about?
I did not finish, but no.
You can't just say they value going down.
Shout out to my nigga Jay. That nigga told me niggas that get bitches should not be with somebody that's a bad bitch. He said,
what?
He called me one day here at Atlanta, nigga. He said, bruh, niggas like me and you, we need to be with bitches that's like sixes and sevens, my nigga, because they the ones that's cool.
They gonna be okay with
some bitch that's a bad bitch.
They not gonna tolerate
the bitches that's like the niggas, every nigga glorify. He like, bro, them ain't the ones for niggas like us. Because, nigga, they going to be crazy. You going to be crazy. You'll be like, what? Nigga.
A woman would never make me crazy.
If you get a bitch that's a 6 or a 7, she going to be cool as fuck.
A woman would never make me crazy.
You said it'd be sixes or sevens. That's crazy too.
No, they're crazy, but they're not gonna make me crazy. Ain't no woman gonna make me crazy first and foremost. That's what I'm getting at.
It depends on what you consider crazy. Over no woman. What are you considering crazy to you then? Like,
I'm stalking. I'm trying to figure out what she is. Like,
you ain't never did that.
Girls in my location. No,
you ain't never did that.
Nah,
you ain't never.
I'm trying to think because you done said some stuff on here. I just can't.
You ain't never. I can't think of nothing. You ain't never, like, I ain't never, like, looked at no location, because I ain't that savvy with the whole location type shit. You feel me?
But, you like, you know she in your area, have you ever looked?
Nah, but I have been like, bitch, let me drive by real quick. You
see what's going on?
You been driving by my house for the past year.
Let you drive by yours. It's morning before you drive by hers.
That was the old me. God gave me a key.
No, the drive-by is stalking.
Yeah.
Have you ever stopped?
But no. My drive-by was like to confirm that she was a hoe.
Did it confirm your intuition?
Yeah, because I've always been right.
I mean, so what? Let's go through that. What some of the lengths y'all went through to confirm whether a lady or not was very friendly with her vagina? What's some lengths y'all went through to figure that out?
Honest to God, dog. The bitches that I fuck with in the past, not present. that are out there, I feel like I done some crazy shit to them that they just try to hurt my my soul so bad that they just tell me, nigga, I was out here last night and this nigga fucked me. And I'm like, ooh.
That's wild.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a wild thing. I'm in a group chat with a lot of people and shit. Like, people I'm cool with, like, you know, it's out for shit. Whatever. And they said, like, one girl was just mad earlier today at her baby fucking daddy. And she like, man, I should say his best friend don't fuck me or ate me. I'm like, oh, wow. I'm like, unless it's true, don't do it.
Like, I would, so like any girl that would ever, I think, would ever tell me that, I couldn't even give her the time of day. Like, if I think you might tell me something crazy like that, I can't ever just take you seriously.
I think that girls be trying to hurt niggas.
No, that's a fact. That's like, a fact.
Me, like, for me, if I ever hurt a girl's feelings, it wasn't like...
intentional.
It wasn't intentional. I was intentional. I intentionally do what I want to do, but I don't be, like, considering feelings.
Your feelings.
You feel me?
But if you're not being considerate, don't that make it intentional?
No, she ain't my main girl.
Because I'm intentionally doing what I want to do.
Like, that's what you're not being considerate of the other person.
How about
that? Because it was on accident. Like, I wanted what I wanted at that moment.
How about this?
But girls do some shit on purpose.
They do it on purpose.
And then they tell you about it. And then they try to shit on you or stun you. Like, this nigga got more bread than you. How you feel? Nigga, how you feel your ex-girl that you knew you broke up with yesterday? Uh-huh. And she just pulled up to your job with a different nigga in a Lambo. Just on purpose. She knows this nigga. They rented it. They just trying to stun.
I like, oh, you ain't feeling still, huh? Yeah, you hurt, girl.
Bitch will do some shit like that. Niggas, we just gonna... fuck some bitches.
Matter of fact, this is way back in my...
that's the problem.
Yeah.
That's the problem.
Bitch. This is back in my heyday, you feel me?
Damn, that's a real question. Can niggas be, like, really faithful?
Yes. We're black men. We don't cheat, so we ain't got no choice.
You must have bought Charlamagne book.
Well, I don't know about his book. I didn't know about facts. I don't know about that.
Niggas just know facts.
Yeah. But, no, like, so, this is younger me, so I'm cool with a girl, right? She love me, whatever. I don't know. I ain't love her back. So one of my...
Why are you so... she love me. I don't love bitch back.
It wasn't right there.
No, it wasn't right there. It's a friend. I told her what it was. God, I told her, she cool. But so, I think because, she didn't watch it. I think because, like, we were cool.
She well, y'all more than cool. She was in love with you.
She tried to get back at me and shit.
You don't love her back, though.
She tried to get back at me. Like, okay.
Why are you impressed if you didn't even love her?
I'm not. I'm telling you the story. It don't even matter.
What happened?
One of my other acquaintances and shit, like, shit. Like, what this is going on. Like, nigga, do that. She's trying to send me fucking screenshots. I'm like, I told the nigga. I ain't say that. I told the nigga, do the shit.
Oh, see.
And she pressed her, like, leave me alone, do the shit, whatever. Do this shit. Please do it. She's still like, fuck you, woo woo. I had to block her. Because I told a nigga do the shit because you weren't my choice of life.
Oh, so you a cold nigga.
And, yeah.
I need to stick the dogs on her.
I didn't.
You stick the dogs on her.
You did it out of spite. It's okay. Ooh. I'm not a spiteful guy. Like,
that was spiteful, my nigga.
On her part.
On yours, too.
How?
Both parts.
How is it spiteful? Bro, I don't give a fuck.
You sent the dog to go get that shit.
No. It's already a mutual thing between them. It's a mutual thing between them.
All right, I feel you.
No, you know you don't.
No, I do, because you saying they was already
so she like, man, I know you're woo-woo-woo. So like, hey, you could, I like, he like, if I know anybody don't give a fuck, I know Trey don't give a fuck. I like, gee, shit, you're right, I don't give a fuck. So she went back, and then she still sent me shit. I'm like, don't send me shit, I don't care.
So when do you give a fuck? Like, how do you know when you give a fuck, though?
Because right. I'm going to tell her I give a fuck. I had to block her.
Oh, you be telling girls you care?
I'm a human.
I am too, but nigga, damn.
No, this is how you say you care. I fuck with you.
It's hard.
No, that's not how you say you care. Not when you're an adult.
I fuck with you?
Not if you're an adult.
Yeah, listen then.
You can't be an adult.
Don't hit a nigga the right way.
That's not how you communicate you care. You. I fuck with you.
No. Okay. I'm paraphrasing. I'm paraphrasing, right?
No, that's not a good paraphrase.
No,
I focus you the long
no.
way. How is a young lady supposed to take that? That's confusing as hell. What does that even mean? What does that even mean? I fuck with you. You know how I feel. I fuck with you.
I fuck with you.
What?
My nigga.
Yeah, funny.
What? But dude, that's how you say you care.
Oh, I'm paraphrasing.
Oh shit.
But if I care about you, women really genuinely know. Like
how though? You say how do they know?
Yeah, how? Like
we
how?
Have the conversations.
Do you gotta bring it up or does she gotta ask you?
It's a median.
What how does the conversation go?
They ask some like shit, like what's good, exclusive shit, maybe not, and then like feelings are expressed.
Is it during like pillow talk, or is it like
no we're cooling? We might be out. Or is it during? I don't pillow talk. If fucking no fucking, it would never happen during fucking. Like if we're gently hanging out,
nigga say a lot of shit when they fucking. Don't even try to play me.
I don't.
Just a quiet fucker.
Borderline.
You a silent fucker.
Borderline.
You tell bitches nothing.
Borderline.
Holy shit!
I'm not telling bitches shit.
Bro. Yeah, like
I used to at one point in my life. I said I'm gonna stop doing that. That's a bad idea. I said it's a bad idea. That's gonna get you in trouble.
Yeah, you right. I had to like learn. My
you grow out of that. Like, let me stop saying shit. Shit, I'm saying get me in trouble.
Go learn my ass in a couple times.
Yeah, damn.
Like,
you said this, and then I'm like, damn,
I can't chill. Unless I ride with you. I might say some shit, but not crazy.
Yeah.
But a lot of women say when I fuck them, like, they're like, damn, you're so quiet. I'm like, I don't know what to do. I'm a quiet nigga.
I'm better now, but before.
You ain't give a fuck.
I used to be out here.
Just saying all kind of
bitch, shit. I love you.
Nah, that's my, like, cutoff.
Yeah.
You feel me?
I like you a lot.
It's like, ooh, this is the best pussy I ever had.
That's what they think they got you.
Yeah, no, fat though.
Past tense. It's not going down like that no more.
Yeah, no.
God should have never made me a daddy because like now I told this straight you're ruthless up. With it. Like I ain't ruthless and reckless, but I ain't about to front. Like I ain't about to act like.
So how do you tell them that you care then?
No, I'm like one of those niggas that's like. Time oriented, like I'm.
So you don't tell him.
Nah.
So you don't tell him more of the story.
Kind of like you might be right. You might be right.
But all those things, I don't know when last time I told a chick I care.
I told people I care.
Some people like I don't even know if you care about me.
I don't know.
Damn. So I'm the toxic person.
No, you are. You should communicate when you care about somebody.
It's hard though.
I'm not.
I agree with you.
Look. I'm not toxic. I care. I'm going to tell you.
You just tell them that you fuck with them.
Yeah, yeah, you're right.
Fuck with you. I care. Tomato, tomato.
I'm about to take notes. I'm about to take notes from you.
Yeah, man.
It's just hard because it's like, if you tell, I feel like for me personally, I feel like the more vulnerable I am with somebody, the more they just gonna not see me open, but more they just gonna think that this shit is like
sweet
going forever.
Yeah,
you feel me? Because females think like, nigga, when a nigga say like, yo, I'm in love with you, I care about you, yada yada yada, they don't even go from that. They go from that to, oh, we this is forever.
Yeah, marriage. Shit.
I don't know 100%, but I'm like 90% sure.
Yeah, forever ain't forever. Don't.
If a nigga tells a girl like, yo, shit, I really care about you, I want to be with you, they instantly jump to the future.
Not always.
And me, I'm scared of the future.
60% of them jump to the future.
I'm scared of the future, my nigga. I don't think I could ever get married. For real.
I feel you. I got my ideologies, but it ain't for this episode. But I got my ideologies.
I always flirt with, you know, is marriage for me or is it not? Only reason why I say yes, because I want you know, a plethora of kids. You know, baby mama stuff don't always go that crazy.
Yeah.
You right.
If. So
stressful.
My thing is, if I get married, I like two wives. I don't want nothing more, nothing less. I gotta have two. One ain't enough.
Well.
But I could be wrong. Somebody might change my shit, but in my mind right
two
now.
Two wives?
I can't have one.
Well, I was kicking with these Muslim girls one time, and they told me.
Shout out to the Muslim
girls. Yeah, shout out to the Muslim girls. Yeah. They kept 100. Because she was a lesbian Muslim girl. And that was
a queen. To be a thing. A queen.
She told me she was
a queen girl.
Yeah, she's a queen, but she told me that wasn't accepted in her family.
It said in the mind.
And in the Muslim culture.
Yeah, it said
but
in
she
the mind.
Told me if you Muslim and you a dude and you have two wives, you got to do everything equally.
Everything. I mean, but that makes sense.
Sexually, financially, time wise. So, nigga, you
gotta
have the energy. So, you got that?
My thing is, if I get married, I need to be a millionaire. So, I ain't gonna.
That ain't nothing to do with the energy. You gotta
distribute everything equally, bro. Like,
that
you
means
can't,
your nigga, time, too.
There's 365 days in a year, my nigga. You gotta be there half the time and here half the time. You make $1 million a year, 500,000 is over here. $500,000.
That's why right now I'm not worried about a relationship.
But, so it's but you said you was trying to be having two wives.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. Once I get in a safe space where I can do that shit, that's cool.
Well, you either got to be Muslim or Mormon. So which one?
No, I don't. No, I don't. I have to be none of that. I got to be financially stable. So
no,
I ain't got to be none of that shit.
Legally do
it's,
that.
It's 100% illegal. Yeah.
Okay.
I
got my main wife and a girlfriend, or I can move to Nevada.
But you said you wanted two wives.
I'm gonna have two.
let's put it into perspective then. By I mean, how you putting that together?
If I'm financially stable, I can do what the fuck I want to do.
Elaborate.
Yeah.
Okay, my money good. Shit, they're going to be certified. What, nigga, if I'm not... This is just...
That ain't an automatic thing. What are you talking about?
You think that's...
I'm find the right one for it.
It's multi-millionaires that be like, that can't get that situation.
Everybody ain't me.
No, for real.
You think Jay-Z
can just pull up at home?
No,
like,
everybody different.
I want you.
You gotta find the right person. You gotta find the right people.
You do, but like, nigga, that's a lot of searching.
It's searching.
I ain't gotta search for shit.
If that's the case, why you ain't got two girlfriends right now?
I don't want one right now. I'm not financially stable right now.
So you
take a trip though. You be gone, my nigga.
I hang out, but when I'm ready for that type of lifestyle, I believe in
fairy tales.
No,
because you got to at least put it into motion now.
Damn. Okay,
you can't just say it. And then
but
you're
I
like,
understand what I understand what you're getting at because one of my niggas told me like basically like nigga like my he's like that nigga told me that nigga meditated. I promise to God, this is one of my closest niggas. I don't even want to put your name out there. But you know I love you. But we had a conversation on the phone, and Blood told me, nigga, I meditated on this shit. That nigga, that God would give me two bitches. Like, not two bitches, because niggas, yeah. Everybody, niggas, girls and got two bitches, niggas got two bitches. Like, he was like, nigga, I literally meditated by myself and said, if God gave me two women that we was just all together, mm-hmm. I would be the happiest man in the world.
Yeah, like, it's not like I'm looking for the shit.
But you should be if that's what you want to do. No, that's what I'm saying. You should be looking for it. That's bro. My whole point.
No.
What's the word? The word of 2021 is manifesting.
Yeah.
You should be trying to manifest.
Yeah, so can y'all hear me out? Got it. Right, mm-hmm. Yeah. So if it happens, cool. If it don't happen, cool. But I'm not against it.
So what are you going to do if it
huh?
If it don't happen, you're going to be sad.
Yeah. No, I'm going to be cool. So that might be the one for me. But if it happened, they might be the two for me.
But if that's what you truly want, why not just
go? And not what I truly want. I'm not against it. I didn't know me.
Now you backpedal.
Yeah,
now
backpedal.
Hey, backpedal. I know me. I'm not searching for two, but I know two work for me. But if one work for me, that's okay. I ain't gotta have two. But two is not far fetched.
So you think you could do that? Would you be able to like be married to two chicks?
I think I know I 100% can.
You can?
Yeah, I know I could. And I mean, maybe something I'm probably gonna end up doing.
Evenly distribute.
Yeah, I could do it no problem.
And all that.
I could do it no problem, honestly. So because that's just my personality type. Like, I need multiple personality people around me just because you know everybody's different. Like, I need somebody that I could just chill with, and I need somebody else that I could go hang out with outside.
But. Do y'all all have to live in the same crib?
Nah, I prefer not.
But does the girl have to be like interested or have some type of not interested sexually, but have some type of like respect for the other girl?
Automatically, because I mean, because I'm going to be gone half the time, so they got to have some form of respect for each other. It's like, okay, I'm gonna allow him to be gone and have this other relationship.
And they gotta kick it?
No, they don't gotta kick it or nothing. But they have to be able to just have mutual respect enough to be to be accepting.
So if you have a kid with both of them.
The kids got to kick it though.
Yeah, that's automatic.
They can sit at different tables. One table over there, table over there.
But the kids
go play the kid table.
Y'all make shit sounds hella good. I'm like, I'm stressed
but
out.
But it
right
really
now.
Women out there for that.
I'm over here scratching my knees and shit. I'm stressed out because I'll be like, I'm sitting here like, damn, I already been in those two
situations. I've
been in love with two different girls, bro. And that shit is not the best feeling.
Is it really, like, is it feasible or, like, logical on be in love with one woman in your fucking life? It's not.
I'm saying at the same time, dog, I've been in love with two different girls at the same time. And that shit had me stressed. I had a big-ass bald spot in my head.
Have you been in love with one woman in your life?
One at one time?
Yeah.
Yeah, and that bitch stressed me out.
So what difference?
No.
That one coming.
This is like a stress of, like, this is stress because we was just beefing a lot.
The stress time, too.
We was just arguing a lot. But when I was in love with two chicks at one time, it was like, what the fuck? You're good, but you're not like this. You're this, but you're fucking crazy. You know what I'm saying? You just you playing ping pong in your own brain that you can't even come up with an answer or no type of solution. And then the only solution you could come up with is like, well, what if they both liked each other, though?
Nah.
That ain't
how you supposed to present that?
Nah. I know they do, but nah. I really got one down for like...
Whatever.
What it is good, like... And I mean, she like females too.
Me personally, I'm good at managing multiple personalities. I'm good at managing that. That's just something I'm very good
and
at.
And I feel like teaching. I am too.
Yeah, I mean, it's just something.
You got to know people. I feel like I never had an issue. Like people know about each other. And I never had an issue. Me personally.
So you just put it out there. You just put it all out there, or what? Is that what it is? Just keep it 100. Just say,
I think that's important.
But how do you go about that though?
I mean, you got to be okay with them not being okay with it.
I'm not okay with just trying, like telling somebody to hurt them. You feel me?
No. You can't do that.
I feel like that's my biggest issue.
They're not hurting them.
I be comfortable with how I am because I know deep down I'm not trying to truly hurt anybody.
Never.
But
it's like
that. But to just present that, I feel like it's not going to come off good.
You present it, though, to prevent the hurt.
Yeah.
So you present it.
The hurt is going to be there regardless.
Nah, you present it and let them make a decision on how they want to react to it.
So do you present it right away? Or after it's already,
Sooner the better. And just keeping a buck on how you feel about everything. Just how you are, how you feel about it, and let them make an adult decision.
So back to your initial question.
Yeah.
Good girl and the right girl.
Yeah.
What if you got a good girl and the right girl and you want to be with them both? How do you handle that situation? Because this is a good girl.
The right girl.
You don't want to let her go because she's the right girl.
The right girl's a bad girl.
Personality wise, but yeah. This is the good girl that you know. Like,
I've had this real situation happen where it's just like, what do? You kind of string both along until you figure it out.
What you just said, you just gonna tell straight up.
I am.
But you wait. You wait.
But it's like, even though I'm breaking, so when you tell them, a lot of times they're not just gonna break it off right away. They might say, "Well, I'm gonna use some time to make a decision." They might do that if they're not with it, or they might just cut you off and be like, "Shit, I ain't with it." Or they might use some time to say, "I ain't with it. Figure it out." And so during that time, you gotta try to figure out what the hell you're gonna do.
I'm willing to
possibly lose both of them I lost a lot of good joints. Yeah, that's some joints I wish they hit me up right now. Like,
so let's say the whole shit switch. Let's say the girl tells you, like, "Nigga, I love you and I love this other nigga." Has that ever happened to you?
And I ain't never done it.
Because we over here being like, you know, male dominant and shit. Like,
we are. Women do that.
Yeah. Women have the same situation.
I'm willing to play my role.
Would you be vulnerable enough and, you know what I mean, submissive enough to be able to say, I can do this.
I can
be with you, and I know you want to be with him too.
I can. As long as you're upfront about it, like,
you think you could really do that?
I did it.
I gotta tell her straight like this, like, look. You gotta put me way ahead of all that. I don't know what else you got going on. I don't even know why you told me that. But you gotta figure it out and put me way ahead of all that. I ain't really into competing for this type of stuff. Otherwise, we just be cool.
Well, man, I must be like a nigga that ain't shit. Because if bitch tell me, I already been in that situation. But me in my head, I'm like, nigga, I'm better than him.
What if she telling you? Nah, y'all even.
Nah, because I feel like when I know myself, bro. So when I feel like when girls that I've been with got a different nigga, I think it's more emotional. I'm not an emotional type of nigga.
Yeah, I feel
so
you.
I feel like I lack the emotional aspects of everything because I'm a fun nigga. I'm gonna have you fuck with me, nigga. Yeah. You gonna be here, nigga. We gonna do a lot of shit. You know what I'm saying?
That fun nigga shit got me in trouble too, but I'm gonna get that's different stuff.
Yeah, that got me in trouble too.
But deep down inside, like, I know that's my biggest insecurity. I know that, like, I'm not the emotional talk to you for long term. Like, I don't have the conversation. I'm like, yo, I think I'm going to be with you.
So, what do you think that makes you better than? Because what if you're like, you just the fun nigga? This the nigga I really like. Because, you just the fun nigga.
Because not only I'm the fun nigga, I'm the nigga that, like, knows you. You feel me? Like, when I fuck with you,
every nigga know that bitch.
Nah, bro. Like, I fuck with people because I grew up there's more women in my family.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, me being around a group of girls is cool with me. I got homegirls. I listen to their opinions. I listen to their fucked up relationships, their good relationships. I understand what's going on. You feel me? So, when I'm with a girl, like, I fuck with you. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, completely. I know that me and you are cool, but I also know that you, deep down inside, are questioning, like, all right, this nigga ain't never talked to me about future shit.
Mm-hmm.
I met this nigga, and right off the gate, he's like, yo, I want to be with you forever. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'll be with you for 7 years and be 20 years and be like, I don't know, I'm nervous. You know what I'm saying? The whole married thing to me, it doesn't even really, like, truly make sense. So it's like,
right, which I feel you on that, too. But that fun nigga shit. It was a period of time where I felt like bitches was just only considering me the fun nigga. I was like, I don't know. Like,
I would embrace that shit.
Yeah,
I was embracing it to a point where it was like, till I came across some of them really solid, good girls. And I was like, they still just view me as the fun nigga. But they solid. Like, I'll fuck around wife with them, but they just view me as a nigga, the fun nigga. It was like, damn, they kind of solid though. Like they could view me as more than that, but it was who I was. I am who I am. Like,
yeah. See, I think my biggest issue is not issue. I don't think it's an issue, but I'm like selective. You feel me? Mm-hmm. I'm not the type of nigga. I ain't gonna say I've been out here, but been out here. So it's like, I understand what I like and what I don't like. You feel me? I understand the difference between a bitch and a B. You feel me? Half quote. But facts though. But I'm saying that to say, like, nigga, when it comes to women, for me, bro, like, I can distinguish who I want to, like, spend my time with. Like, I don't fucking put my time and effort into, like, girls that I don't see that's a good chick. You know what I'm saying? Like, I might kick it with you for a small period of time if I think you just cute.
Yeah.
But you ain't going to be at my house. You ain't about to be cuddling. We ain't about to be out. We ain't about to be doing all this extra
activity.
But,
no, that's, so it's like, it's just hard for me to like understand where I'm at with it, because I select myself and put myself into situations with girls that are good women. You feel me?
No,
so that's why I fucked me up.
No, I'm saying that's cool and shit, but like he was saying earlier, like shit, they see you at a certain type of nigga, but when you see them as that potential and shit, whatever. And they don't reciprocate that feeling, like, it might be, it is what it is. So, like, I've been in the same boat or whatever. Like, oh, you just a fun nigga, so maybe try to change that point of view for them. Do it work all the time? No. Maybe it do, but sometimes it might be too late.
For me, bro, like, I've never been in that situation where it's just like, I like the girl more than she likes me. Because, again, I'm very selective. You get what I'm saying? Like, I could feel the vibe. You know what I mean? Like, if I feel like you ain't vibing with me like that, I'm just instantly, I'm naturally a nigga that doesn't really show his emotion. I'm naturally a nigga that doesn't give a fuck. Like, it takes more energy and effort for me to care about you. Like, not care about you, but like,
Show that I care.
You feel me? And like actually put the time in and hang out with you. So when I do, that means I really fuck with you. You know what I'm saying? So that's what fucks me up. It's not all the bitches in the world, because nigga, there's a lot of pretty women in the world. It's not that. It's always like, damn, she's a good girl. Like in the last like what 5-10 years of my life, I've only really been around girls that I look at as like, yo, I could really be with you. So
that's saying something.
Because the girls saying something. Because the girls that I've like been with that I just fuck with and shit like that, nigga, it's a very there is no misunderstanding.
Yeah.
I don't even have you feeling like this is a misunderstanding. Mm-hmm. There is no deep down inside. There's no deep dog, nigga. It's like, boom. I know I don't fuck with you.
Yeah.
Like that. So, I'm not gonna. If a girl's cute as fuck, and I know I don't fuck with you, and she's like, yo, let's go on a trip right now, she pays for all this shit, I'm not gonna go.
Right.
I'm not going to go, nigga. If a girl's like, come over, and she's the baddest bitch, and I know I don't like you, nigga, I might go, I might fuck you, but I'm not staying tonight. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know how to.
Depending on what time it is, because
sweet time. It be time.
Yeah, you out, huh?
On my mama, bro, like, I'm leaving.
Yeah.
Because the more time and the little cuddling and the little,
that shit adds up.
I don't feel like I let people on, but I feel bad because it seemed like I let them on.
I'm going to tell this nigga that from day one. But yeah, there you go.
I'm older now. Like, I did not accident, nigga, be tired. I'm gonna sleep over, cut a little bit, cause shit, you're warm. But the older I got, it like, you don't think shit is bigger, like a big deal, but to them, it might be a big deal.
Nah, because if you, man,
I say no, trust me. I told them what it was before.
But what's
I told women, the misunderstanding was a big deal. I told her, we just gonna be friends. Yes, we fucking, we doing whatever. But a lot of people think they could change you.
That's not your issue, though.
I think so, too, but I'm gonna still feel bad, because
I don't feel bad. I don't feel bad about that type of shit.
I got a heart. I feel bad.
I got a heart, too, but look, my nigga, I got a heart, too. But if a girl thinking she just about to just she think in her own mind that she could just fucking.
If they like you a lot, most women gonna think like that.
I don't give a fuck, nigga. I have no sympathy for that type of shit.
I do.
I don't. I'm not even gonna act like. So if any of y'all is out here listening, if you think that like you're gonna change me in like a way that you want me to be, it's not gonna happen.
No, I agree. I say the same shit. I say that all the time, but I'ma still feel bad because that's just how people think, women think. I'm pretty sure dudes think the same shit. I'ma change this hoe into a housewife. It happens sometimes. No. I wouldn't do it, but people think this way, so who am I to knock them for thinking this way?
I'm not them for thinking that too.
I don't think I'm not I don't think you're wrong for thinking that. I'm just telling you, thinking about me.
Yeah, no, they're wrong
for thinking that. For thinking they can change.
I'm G Street. I'm always G Street, so I'm letting you know what it is. But I feel bad because I'm a. To some people, I am a great guy, but I'm a great guy. So you having a false perception of me. I'm telling you what it is. Anything could wipe me up, which is not the case. And then you mad at me for it not happening. I feel bad.
Well, how do you prevent that situation?
I cut them off and I don't go that avenue. I ain't got time.
But that's what I'm saying. That's why.
Maybe y'all I'm too selective. Maybe understand. It was early in my year, but maybe I too late in cutting them off because I like.
Sex. I'm cutting them off at that point.
I like.
Sex. I figured it out, bro. I was in. Nigga, I'm telling you.
That was early though. That was years ago.
Made me a dad. Once I became like a fucking real dad, like it is like it's not cutthroat. But I'm definitely not about to just like.
Perception changes. Perception changes.
I'm not about to just hang out with you consistently if I don't fucking fuck with you as a person. I'm the type of person where I have to fuck with you as a person, dog. Like, relationships and shit is fucking comes and goes. Mm-hmm. Best friends, girlfriends, titles and shit come and go.
But titles are not important.
The actual person, if you understand the person and you fuck with them, that's different, my nigga. You can't just get that with everybody. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Sex, you can fuck so many girls. Girls can fuck so many dudes. If a girl is out here, bro, mm-hmm. and they was thinking like niggas, we'd be out here hurt.
Devastated.
Every day. Devastated.
That's very true.
Like, you know how hard it would be to be married to Kim Kardashian?
Kanye learned the hard way.
That nigga learned the hard way. That's
he
what I'm
knew
saying.
What's up. Shout out to Ray J. He knew what's up.
And Ray J, my nigga, that I ain't no homo. That's one of my favorite niggas.
Though. No, like, you heard the shit that he say. I seen Faith Evans said it's old shit. Don't even matter. But he said I seen Faith Evans watching like, man the fucking biggest thing on Tupac lap. That literally just came out. But he was 15, 14 years old. That's neither here or there, but
I ain't even gonna front. Ray J, nigga, I've watched this nigga move and maneuver.
Look.
I've always looked at the nigga like, nigga, this Ray. Is how I be. I've a lot of situations and a lot of niggas I grew with, you know, we LA niggas, you know.
Yeah.
Nigga, I don't know what it is, nigga, state to state. I feel like we be out here in LA having a great time.
Do you know how much I fuck with Ray J? I got Raycon. Shout out to the back. I got Raycon.
Let's do a wholesome hot seat. So these gonna
shout out
ask questions, just rapid fire answers. Alright, so wholesome hot seat. If you could be invisible, would you spy on your spouse? Rapid fire. 3, 2, 1, go. No. Trey, you said you spying?
Yeah,
I'm spying. Spying. If I'm invisible, I'm spying.
I'ma say no just because, nigga, I don't wanna see her.
You nigga gonna see too much.
I'm be hurt, but I'm with the shit.
Nigga gonna see too much.
I don't want to see everything. The reason why I don't want to see everything is because I don't want to have to push that into the next thing. I've been in situations where I put the fucked up past shit into the new shit. I don't even want to see that.
That definitely could happen.
I don't want that.
That's very easy. Case.
I don't want that. I don't want to have a superpower where I could just see everything you're doing.
Okay, nah,
I'm at the point right now. The girl let her phone run in front of me. Nigga, girls, like, give me your phone like this. Nigga. I don't want to see nothing, dog. I don't want to see anything. I don't want to know nothing, dog. Makes unless sense. You tell me. Unless it just naturally, universe energy, nigga. That's what I'm on right now. Like, if the universe brings this shit to me, it's there. But I'm not. No, I don't want to be visibly seeing shit.
Wholesome hot seat. Two physical traits you want to see on a woman.
Ass and titty. I'm playing.
Ass and good teeth.
Good teeth.
Yeah, I don't care about the titties. I
honestly like a good booty.
Yeah, that's number one.
And a good, I love hair. Girls that got like clean, fresh hair, that shit is like the best shit.
You can be bald headed as long as it put well.
No.
Knee long?
No.
Knee long with a
little. Knee long
is fine. Yeah, a little bald headed knee long.
Until you grab her head.
I don't need that much.
And that shit feels like yours.
You palming her
head. Yeah, it feels like yours.
Yeah.
I don't need much.
No. Until it feels like yours.
Okay. Like, damn, she got a perm. Short hair, prime curls.
That's funny. Last one, Wholesome Hot Seat. What scares you most about dating?
Not knowing.
Not knowing what?
Anything.
Not knowing anything.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
That really, anything.
Nothing.
You don't know what's going on the whole time, every time.
You don't
know. That's serious. Like, right. That really my biggest, that might be my biggest fear.
What's yours?
My biggest, I like dating, but the thing I'm most scared about, just being played like a sucker.
I'm
okay with not knowing. Just make sure that treat me like I'm supposed to be treated.
No, I'm Mario Wanda. So like, he don't want to know. I want to know.
Like, so like, don't, an example would be. Like, you can keep it, I guess it is not knowing. That's kind of the same thing.
And mine not knowing is like...
Like, just keep it a buck with me.
So, for my not knowing, bro, it's like, all right, I don't want to be out with some girl, and she ain't going to tell me, like, yo, this is a nigga right here.
That's what I'm saying.
That I used to fuck with, and he a little crazy. And then I'm over here dancing with her and shit, grooving, and then I get popped in my head, nigga. Like, what the fuck happened to me?
No, that's definitely not cool.
I'm saying I've been in. I ain't never got hit by some random nigga, but I've been into situations.
Like, and
she ain't like, yo, just want to let you know, like, this is a dude I used to talk to.
No, that's a problem.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know if I ever look at you the same way because you walk You walk me into a fucking.
It's a dangerous situation.
Yeah, you walk me into a wolf's den. And now I'm sitting over here like, this nigga is with seven other niggas. I'm just with me and you. And this nigga, wherever he is mentally, or.
This nigga with my girl.
That nigga.
You gotta tell me that type of stuff. If you don't tell me that, like, you putting my life in danger. Like,
that shit real.
That's my not knowing.
Like, yeah, just knowing all the situations you've been in, like, it's a lot of facts.
Yeah, that's my not knowing. Cause I ain't the most honest nigga, but if I see a bitch out,
I'm black, I'm honest.
I'm gonna tell you, like, oh, you got to.
The next girl is here.
Right, but you know,
us as black men. What's your name again? We didn't ask for your opinion on nothing.
Well, her opinion don't cheat.
It don't matter right now. She ain't.
But what we do know is that black men don't cheat. This has been the Wholesome Podcast. We appreciate you for coming through.